Hey guys, good evening. So let's talk about underwater pictures. So let's say if you are on a vacation to some amazing location which has got like amazing beaches, you shouldn't be returning back without some epic underwater pictures. When I talk about epic underwater pictures, let me just show you some examples. Okay, so the very first thing you need is a GoPro, of course, unless you have a really expensive case for your DSLR or mirrorless camera. So we're just talking about GoPros here because it's cheap, inexpensive, good to go. So first thing first, you need a GoPro first. The second thing is you need this lens, this dome lens. This is huge, the box is huge again. But this is not that expensive, let me tell you. It's just, I guess, $30 or $40 in India. It's somewhere like, I guess, 5,000 or 6,000 bucks. I have left all the links below in the video description in case you're looking to go ahead and buy it. So all of the magic which you just saw in the pictures has been done with this dome lens. The third thing you need to do is set your GoPro to time-lapse photo mode so that you don't have to tinker with the photo again and again. Basically, this dome has the feature of pressing the GoPro button over here, so you don't have to do that again and again. Just set the GoPro to time-lapse photo mode. Let it take all of the pictures, go ahead, see the pictures, select the pictures which you need to do, edit, upload, that's it. So basically the pictures which you just saw has been done with this lens. I did it in the Indian Ocean and the pool both. So that's pretty much it. That is the shortest tutorial I could have done for getting those epic underwater pictures. And if I have to tell you more, the best thing you can do is set the POV to wide, do not use the linear mode, and just use it for 0.5 seconds for the time-lapse mode on the GoPro. So that's pretty much it. It's the easiest thing to do. Just get this dome lens, set your GoPro to time-lapse photo mode, do it, go ahead and get it done. Now, how to use this dome lens? You just have to make sure you're not immersing this completely under the water. You have to keep it, half of it on the top of water and half of it needs to go on the bottom of the water. The best sweet spot is I normally keep the lens completely out of the water and the rest half inside the water. So that is all about how you need to use this dome lens.
So if you have got any questions, just let me know in the comment section below. Smash the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to stay updated. I will see you next time. Peace.